Well, since you guys are both Alfieri's, tell me a little bit about Alfieri's for the people who are new to the area.
Okay, it originally was Renner's Pharmacy, and the three brothers, my dad and my two uncles, Tony, Lou, and Vince, all bought the pharmacy from Mrs. Renner after Mr. Renner died. And Dad had been working up here at Eckert's Department Store as a manager in the store. And he knew Mrs. Eckert, or Mrs. Renner, and so she asked them if they would be interested in buying it because she didn't want to run it any longer. And she, you know, didn't have a pharmacist or anything. So they bought it from her. And that became Alfieri Pharmacy from then on.
What are your fondest memories of Alfieri's?
Oh, the soda fountain was one of big.
I think you've got to say the soda fountain. Yeah. I mean, it was one of the premier places, stops for everybody from McNicholas, and when Withrow came, all the Withrow kids came home, they'd get off the bus right there, and a lot of them would head down to Rainbow, and a lot of them would head over a place, but they'd always stop right there, and that place was just buzzing from 2:30 to 4:30.
Because you had a fountain.
Yeah.
Huh? Say where it was.
Yeah. Yeah. Right there, Beachmont and Corbley.
Beachmont and Corbley.
Where Walgreens.
Yeah. Where Walgreens is now.
Yeah, right where Walgreens is right now.
Now, a little birdie told me that somebody was a soda jerk.
We both
were. Is that what it's called?
Yeah.
Tell me a little bit about what are soda jerks.
Well, they're people who actually make sodas and work behind the counter of a soda fountain, you know. And we mixed up drinks there. We had the
mostly malt
fizzy
sodas.
Water and everything to make actual sodas and sundaes and everything else.
Well, Cokes were 5 cents a piece. Pepsis were 5 cents a piece. And French Bauer ice cream is what we dealt with it back in those days. We could get a single dip for 7 cents.
Two dips for 12 cents. 2 cents for the cone and a nickel for each dip of ice cream.
I think Graters.
Graters we sold, but we only sold it in pints.
Oh.
Yeah.
We didn't sell it as bulk.
Yeah.
The French Bauer we did. And some of my fondest memories were being there in the morning when guys like Bob Burwell would show up with ice from Mt Washignton Ice and Beer. And the guy that showed up from French Bauer was there.
Yeah.
I'm trying to remember his name.
I can't remember his name.
Oh, he's a great guy, though.
But he used to deliver ice cream once a week from French Bauer.
Big 5 gallon tubs that he sold. And I think, you know, the guys that were drugstore cowboys, so to speak, that were always at the thing, I mean, and there was a lot of them. And they were from, like I said, all walks of life, from very, very wealthy families in Watch Hill down to, you know, some people that, you know, didn't have much to go on, but everybody was friends and everybody got along really well in there. And especially since my dad was there, because he ruled it like a roost. I mean, there was no messing around, you know. You had good time, but that was it, you know. And he was very strict about that kind of stuff, but everybody liked him. He just kept order, that's all. And he ran the whole the sundry side of the store and everything, and Lou did most of the bookwork, and Tony was in the back as a pharmacist.
Marie Fritch?
Yeah,
Marie. Yeah. She was a cosmetic lady.
Yeah.
Took care of all the cosmetics at the store.
She was like a fixture there.
Yeah.
And Marie's brother, Will, Wild Bill, he used to come in every once in a while, and he'd sit there and tell stories of his past, how he ran in the Indianapolis 500. He was a race car driver. He loved the ponies.
Yeah,
he was just a
wild
man.
Mostly hung out down the track these days. He was retired and just hung out at the racetrack.
And another fixture was Harry Lenzer. Harry Lenzer worked there along with Irv Burbrink in the evenings. And some interesting stories there is Irv was a baseball coach up here, coached the Alfieri's baseball team along with the Guardian Angel team and a number of other things. But Harry Lenzer, I think, was most noted for the fact that he was the one that made all of the lights that went on the tower. Every one of those was fabricated by him, by Harry Lenzer.
Yeah.
can't talk about Mount Washignton without
Sarge. Sarge was a fixture there too.
Yeah,
he was a great guy. He got into a lot of trouble along with other people like Dates and Denny Casey and people like that. And Dates was actually related to Linda's one uncle, and back in those days, they were starting to get into some trouble. So Al Klug, that ran Mount Washignton Ice and Beer, and Dad got together, and Al Klug hired Dates, and Dad hired Sarge, and they just did odd jobs, and he was at that drugstore all the time. People thought we were related to him for a long time.
Well, he used to come to family parties and everything
The man could eat.
Yes, he could.
He would stop by Mt Washignton Bakery and they'd give him a dozen buns. Just buns. He'd sit there and eat a dozen buns. He's no bigger than a minute, but he'd eat a dozen buns. He could really chow down.
He walked many miles, didn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah.